intelligence and working, you know, as a technical advisor and trying to pass good legislation in Brazil. I will, you know, really appreciate, you know, any remarks if you send. That's why I left my email, and there is my email in the program as well. It's really a good chance to exchange ideas and find a way, you know, to get better public policy. Thank you.
Well, if you want a clear and straight answer, I will say no, there should not be corporate funding. I think democracy is about human beings, and there should not be corporate funding or union funding or any kind of funding behind legal structure that hides the real people with name and last name. Like, for example, a trust in Mexico, there used to be this form of founding parties through a trust, which maintains anonymity. I think that shouldn't be admissible. About political parties and sanctions, si me permiten, le voy a contestar en español. Creo que en México el problema que tenemos es que tenemos un exceso de sanciones. Hoy nuestra ley electoral es más que nada un catálogo de restricciones que se ha vuelto imposible de cumplir. Creo yo que tendríamos que tener una revisión integral de la ley, escoger bien las restricciones que se deben de tener. Sin lugar a dudas, tiene que haber restricciones, y esas restricciones tienen que tener sanciones claras y precisas que no dejen a la interpretación de la autoridad, si es que son sistemáticas y reiteradas o no. Creo que el problema es que en México hemos pecado en la cantidad de sanciones que tenemos, que finalmente tampoco evitan todas las, o no han mejorado la postura ética de los partidos.
Scandals drive change or not drive change, and trying to answer also to the person from Podemos. I think our real question, and that could be like for a year of research in a university, is when and why political parties disengage from the people. And I think that's important. And what kind of rules we have made that have had the unintended consequences that maybe foster this disengagement, or what can we or should we do to reverse that? And I think we have to believe in a representative democracy. Maybe we can adapt some measures of direct democracy, such as referendum, but we cannot eliminate representative democracy with a reasonable circulation of elites and a possibility to include newcomers. One thing that all the countries that were, and that includes Spain, in the third wave of transition, we have to answer is how political parties and political party systems corrupt so quickly. I think that the circulation of elites were so close that in a very few years, and in the span of time in history, 30 years is very few years, the political parties start to show signs of hemophilia, and they become really diseased, and they have really to attend that, because that is a disease of democracy. Thank you.
There's no consensus on the political financing from two sources, the public and the private sources, so I'd like to just give a final remark.
It's only a final in the sense that I owe a better answer to our friend from India. Even though I've answered the question very directly, no funding from corporations. How we achieved it, though, might be of interest. The government approached me as chief electoral officer and said, we want to do this. What do you recommend? And so what we did, and then we shared all of this with the parliamentary committee that was considering the law, the bill that the government was proposing. We tabulated all of the corporate contributions to the political parties, because all this was public. We gave it for each party, and we said, if you eliminate corporate funding, this is how much public funding you will have to give through a per vote subsidy. And that's where initially the per vote subsidy, which was done away with, was $1.50. Because if they got $1.50, the political parties, to the votes that they'd gotten, there was no longer a need for corporate funding or union funding. So we were holding them harmless. And that made the measure acceptable. Then it became a discussion about whether you believe corporations and unions should have, you know, an opportunity to contribute, or whether you believe in a different definition of democracy. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Just a few reflections, and because this is a major issue. Again, there's no consensus. This is context dependent. What is really the issue? What is really the concern? And if we see the corporations, the majority of the countries, they have certain bans on foreign contribution from corporations, from state-owned enterprises, or with contracting relationships, etc., etc. It's not a general ban. Actually, you could find quite detailed about the threshold, the sources from this OECD forthcoming publication. But again, what really matters, what is the context? And just to give, we talked about from different perspectives, level playing field. But level playing field is totally different when we are using the term, you know, the rich man democracy. So donating to all of the candidates, or when you are excluding, for example, lobbyists from the election campaign. And it's a totally different concept of level playing field. But more importantly, I think this is important to see what is behind the rules, not only the implementation, but what is the actual application. For example, many countries, they have this equilibrium of public and private sources, corporation, not only individual, but corporation. But they are not using, for example, in the United States, because the public sources require certain level of transparency and spending. Similarly, when you talk about what is the impact, like excluding politicians or the impact on politicians, political career, of course, the role of and the impact of independent institutions, whether it's election court or whether this is the prosecutor or investigators and prosecutors. And just giving this example recently as the immediate impact of the Petrobras case, a dozen politicians in the Congress, they were arrested, investigated and arrested. And this is still going on in the executive. So I think these are very clear messages. What I'd like to again highlight that this holistic approach, what I felt, linking the various measures, but also the data available, how sometimes procurement contracts, reforms in specific policies, legislators, they are linked to previous donations, etc. I think we need to take, and the big data provides, and this is what we were discussing with International Idea, how we could further develop this better understanding of the impact. So I thank you so much. I thank you so much, all Maria, Jean-Pierre, and Anna, for engaging in this very open-minded discussion. I thank you so much for the open discussion from the floor, and also for organizing the session. Thank you so much.